I am going to teach you nearest neighbor classifier. The previous videos I have posted the other classifiers such as decision tree classifier, naive Bayesian classifier and the rule based classifier. In this video I am going to post I am going to explain nearest neighbor classifier. Yes. So what is classification? Yes. We are going to classify a particular instance and we are going to predict whether they will, that instance will come under which category, which class label. That is the ultimate aim of all the classifier. That is the use of all the classifier. So what we are going to, how our nearest neighbor classifier is going to help us in predicting the class label. The basic idea is, if it walks like a duck, quacks like a duck, then its probability is a duck. So if it satisfies two conditions, if a bird is there and if it satisfies two conditions like it walks like duck and quacks like duck, then the probability of the bird being a duck is more. So I will classify that bird as a duck. Okay, if it walks like with the distance between the two legs as 10 centimeter and the quack, the sound is of the same duck sound, then we will classify that bird as a duck. The probability of the bird being a duck is more. So with that, we are going to classify, with the help of this concept, we are going to classify in the nearest neighbor. Yes, we'll see. So it requires the following: a set of labeled records, proximity metric. What is proximity? So already we have seen in the module 3 that similarity and dissimilarity measures has to be calculated. So to predict which to classify a particular instance. So how can we calculate the similarity or dissimilarity? We had seen so many formulas, Euclidean distance, Manhattan distance, so many techniques we have seen. Using that we can calculate the proximity and we can classify the items based on the distance or similarity measures. We have 2-3 birds, and if we have birds like peacock, parrot and duck. I have a bird which sounds which quacks, only duck will quack, right? So which the bird quacks like a duck and it walks like a duck. So I will classify that bird as a duck and not as a peacock or parrot. So what I'm doing here, I'm classifying a bird to either duck or parrot or peacock. So if it satisfies the similarity features of the duck, then I will classify it as a duck. If it satisfies the similarity features of parrot, then I will classify it as parrot. Or if it satisfies the similarity features of peacock, then I will classify the bird as a peacock. So the same thing is applied here in the nearest neighbor classifier. If the similarity between the bird and the duck is more, after calculating the distance similarity measure, then we will classify that particular bird as a duck. If the dissimilarity between the bird and the peacock is more, then I will say that it is not peacock. The bird is not peacock. So whichever the similarity is more, then I will classify it to a duck or peacock or parrot. So with the help of the similarity measures, distance or dissimilar or similarity or dissimilarity measures, we are going to classify a particular instance to that class label. The value of the k, the number of nearest neighbors to retrieve. So how many number of nearest neighbors can be found is nothing but the k. A method for using class label of k nearest neighbors to determine the class is unknown record. Yes, take the majority vote of the class labels among the k nearest neighbors. So we have to take the majority vote of the class labels. So among the three, see, let the value of the k be 3. I have to search for the 3 nearest neighbors, whichever. See, I said like I have a bird which has the similarity, one or more similarities with 3 birds like parrot, peacock and duck. So what I have to do, I have to take the majority vote of the class labels among the K, which is having majority vote, major number of votes that should be taken, and weigh the vote according to the distance. How I have to weigh the vote? Based on the distance measure, have to weigh, and I have to classify the bird as either duck or parrot or peacock, and the weighing factor is equal to 1 by d square. Yes, I'll show with a simple example to make you understand the K nearest neighbor classifier. Okay, so this is the tabular column which shows a set of data. So this is my training set, we can assume. See here, the students who got 4 in max and 3 marks in CS, their result was fail. And the student whose mark in max is 6 and CS is 7 is pass. Like this, we have few marks of the students and their results. Now our task, our classifier, the task given to our classifier, that is K nearest neighbor classifier, is we have to calculate for a instance which is not in this table. We have to classify the result of the instance which is not there in the table. What is the instance given to us for which we have to find the result? A student is, the instance is nothing but x. So x is equal to max. In a student got 6 marks in max and 8 marks in CS. So what will be his result? Whether the same value is there in this tabular column? No, we don't have. Now our classifier comes into the picture and it is going to classify what is the result of this student. So for this, what we have to do, as we said, we have to find the similarity or dissimilarity measure. So we are going to calculate the distance between the P and Q. So this is the Euclidean distance formula which we have already seen. So d of P comma Q is equal to root of square root of summation of I is equal to 1 to 1 Qi minus Pi the whole square. So if we have 8 attributes, then 8 times we have to find the difference between the two rows. Since we have only the 2 attributes, only twice we have to submit the difference between the attributes and we should come out with the answer. So what is our instance? Max is 6 and CS is 8. So I am taking square root of, what is my Q value here? Q value for the first attribute is 6. So 6 minus, what is the Q value of the record which already exists? I am going to compare my instance for which I have to find the result with the all the rows in the given data set. So I am taking 6 minus 4 whole square plus 8 minus 3. What is the value of the CS in the given instance? 8, and in the data it is 3. So 8 minus 3 whole square. So 6 minus 4 is 2, 2 square is 4, 8 minus 3 is 5, 5 square is 25, 25 plus 4, 29, root of 29 is equal to 5.3. Then second thing, what I have to do, this instance by the second record. So 6 minus, what is the max value of second row? 6. 6 minus 6 whole square plus 8 minus 7 whole square. So 6 minus 6 is 0 whole square plus 8 minus 7 is 1. 1 square is 1. So root of 1 is 1. Similarly, I am taking 6 minus third row, that is 7. 6 minus 7 whole square plus 8 minus 8 whole square, which is equal to, so minus 1 whole square will be 1 plus 8 minus 8 is 0. So 1 square is 1. Square root of 1 is 1. Then again, this value with the next row, that is fourth row, it is 6 minus 5 whole square plus 8 minus 5 the whole square, which is equal to 1 square plus 3 square. So 1 plus 3 square is 9, that is root of 10, which is equal to 3.1. then take this instance, subtract with the respective attribute values, that is 6 minus 8, स्क्वायर प्लस 8 - 8 होल स्क्वायर. सो -2, 8 - 6 इज -2, होल स्क्वायर इज 4, प्लस 8 - 8 इज 0. सो रूट ऑफ 4 इज नथिंग बट 2. सो दीज आर द वैल्यूज विच दीज आर नथिंग बट द यूक्लिडियन डिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस इंस्टेंस विथ every row which is there in the data set. So what we have to find, we have to now classify the result, either it is it whether it is a pass or fail. So what we have to take, we have to take the distance which is very less. Okay, the aim of the k nearest neighbor is we have to find the x value. See here, we have to find the x value. This is the instance x. We have to find the three values, that is k values, which is nearer to this x. It can be this value, or it can be this value, or it can be this layer. So we want three values which is nearer to x. Okay, that's what it is called as k nearest neighbors. We have to find the three neighbors which is nearer to this instance. So if the value of the k is 3, then it is k nearest neighbor. If the value of the k is 4, then we have to calculate 4 nearest neighbors. Okay. Now we will assume that k is equal to 3 and we will determine the 3 nearest neighbors of our instance x. What is our instance? A student got 6 marks in max and 8 marks in CS. Okay. So which is having minimum distance we have to select. So those, because nearest neighbor we said, right? So which is nearest we have to check. So the difference or distance should be less. So if you find the distance, whichever is lesser distance, this is there and this is there and this is there. So these are the three distances which are less from x. So what is this distance? Second row. So this is second row. And this is in the third row and this is fifth row. So in every row, if you find the result, it is pass. So the out of three nearest neighbors, all the three are having the result as pass. The probability is 100% out of the three nearest neighbor, all the three are having pass. The probability of passing is 100% here. So we will say that the result is pass. Clear? So we can classify the result as pass. This is how with the help of the nearest neighbors, we are classifying that our instances also will belong to this class called either pass or fail. So I hope you would have understood how to classify the instance, particular instance, with the help of the k nearest neighbors. Thank you.